And welcome to this week's episode of TulipTV. Hi, Tom.
Hey, Renske. Here's what's coming up.
Coming up this week on TulipTV, the Consul General introduces us to speed skating, we spend some time at the Queen's Day reception in Vancouver, and we visit the lovely city of Utrecht. All coming up on this week's episode of TulipTV.
This program is sponsored by Dutch, the full-color English language magazine about the Netherlands and its people, at home and abroad. Canada to Leave is the online community for the Dutch living in Canada and the Canadians living in the Netherlands. Canada to Leave, wherever you live.
The occasion was the speed skating. Unfortunately, our famous 11 city tour in the Netherlands didn't happen. It was very close, but the ice was not thick enough. So we already calculated that it would be difficult again, because the last one was in 99, I believe. So we said, let's organize an alternative 11 city tour in Sylvan Lake in Alberta. And of course, we always profit from the occasion to do also some other things. We come a lot in Alberta. Alberta is known for its oil sands, for its energy industry. We work closely together with many companies. The Dutch are known. We help out in cleaning the tailing ponds. We supply all sorts of material to the energy sector. But that's what we do in, let's say, Calgary, in Edmonton, of course, where the government is, and Fort McMurray. But Alberta is also known for its agricultural sector, and they are trying to move ahead. They are very ambitious. They want to apply new technology. They want to add value. And they look at us, at the Dutch. First of all, there are a lot of Dutch people of Dutch descent, who have immigrated to Alberta. And they are already involved in the agricultural business, in horticulture, in the agro-food, food processing. But they want to improve and using the latest technology. Now, as you know, one of the 9 top sectors in the Netherlands is agro-food. We have our university in Wageningen. We have a lot of other important green schools in the Netherlands. So we like to work together with Red Deer, where the main agricultural center is of Alberta, and see what we can do together. So we organized a meeting, and that meeting was well attended, I should say. First of all, we had the privilege of the Minister of International Relations, Cal Dallas. Then we had a few MLAs, some of them of Dutch descent, like Mr. Ray Prince. And we were honored by the visit of 2 mayors, the one of Red Deer and the one of Sylvan Lake South. Now, the last one was very interesting because we had an informal chat together, and she told me, well, yesterday I have also been on the ice, I've been skating. I said, well, when I was a little bit younger, I used to skate a lot. Let's do it together. I said, okay. So on the day of the marathon, the 100 kilometers, we did two laps of 5 kilometers, one practice and one serious one. And we arrived together at the finish, of course, holding hands. And I think that was a very nice occasion also to further bond what we have already between the Netherlands and Canada. So I believe such visits are useful, and we should do this much more.
Thank you. reception. This year, as you can see in the beautiful Van Dusen Garden, in the brand new visitor center. We feel privileged to celebrate Her Majesty's official birthday in such a wonderful environment. The Netherlands has been one of the main destinations for Canadian export to Europe for a long time, but maybe not all of you know that since very recently, the Netherlands has become the largest investor in Canada after the United States. We're a small country, only 60 million people. The ties between British Columbia and the Netherlands are strong, historically. The Dutch were among the people who built up this part of the world, especially in the Lower Mainlands. And I see a lot of familiar faces who are part of this building up. Nowadays, British Columbia is called the gateway to Asia. From BC, the agriculture products from the prairies and the natural resources from the whole of Western Canada are transported to Asia and vice versa. Are the consumer goods from Asia, Walmart, transported to the whole of Canada and even to big parts of the United States through British Columbia. You must have heard the Premier, Mrs. Christy Clark, talking about this all the time. Gateway to Asia. Well, that sounds familiar. The Netherlands has a similar position in Europe. And for that reason, we are called the gateway to Europe. I already mentioned that we work together in the fields of transport, infrastructure and logistics, but I'm convinced that we can do much more in those fields, especially because we are not competitors. Your market is Asia, ours is Europe. We can learn from each other. Your gateway concepts can be tested in Europe and ours here. Pleasure of traveling around in this country. I meet a lot of people of Dutch descent. Out of the total population of Canada of 34 million today, 1 million are of Dutch descent. So it's a sizable group, and we've done very well. We are, as our Consul General has mentioned, the second largest investor in Canada. So I think you could say that, you know, we're a small country in size, but we have a large footprint in Canada. Or, you know, we've come a long way, like this girl on our wooden shoes. We're celebrating Queen's Day, which is something that we're all looking forward to, and actually I'm very happy to start today, and I take it all for the weekend, and I end on Monday in Ottawa, so the Dutch will really know how to party. But also at the same time, on a day like this, I cannot but think also of Her Majesty and what happened to the family earlier this year with a very tragic ski accident and her second son who's in a coma and nobody knows what is going to happen. So. On a day like this, also think of Her Majesty and her family for that reason. Let me end on a positive note. Once again, it's great to be here, very happy to be here. And I have the honor to ask all of you who speak English, Dutch I should say, to join me in singing our national anthem, Het Wilhelmus. Thank you very much.
Just the best. Good luck.
No, tomorrow is a big day. D-Day. Or T-Day, I would say, right? It's T-Day, I guess.
It's T-Day, yeah. It's Tulip Day tomorrow. 3:30 on Shaw.
Wining and dining, Utrecht.
Utrecht is situated in the heart of the Netherlands, only 40 kilometers southeast of Amsterdam. The city is home to over 300,000 people. Utrecht's old city centre offers a wide variety of trendy restaurants, shops and cultural activities. Many festivals and events are held throughout the year. And because of its central location, Utrecht is ideally situated for fairs and conventions. Utrecht's canals and wharfs enjoy worldwide fame. No other city in the world has pedestrian curbs along the water quite like Utrecht.
Sometimes referred to as the Venice of the North, Utrecht is most beautiful from the water.
Were constructed centuries ago to provide access to the cellars underneath the buildings along the water. A boat trip down the Oude en Nieuwe Gracht gives you a full tour around the city centre.
This is really unique. After every bridge you have this new painting coming out.
On a sunny afternoon like this, you'll find many people on and along the canals.
Cheers. Of course you can take a trip on the canals of Utrecht, but if you want to do something different, I'd recommend a trip on the Vecht, where you can really see some beautiful architecture.
Indeed, Mark. Historic buildings of all sizes and shapes line the Vecht. Appropriate surroundings to enjoy a glass of champagne.
Bigger.
Canada to Leave is the online community for the Dutch living in Canada and the Canadians living in the Netherlands. Canada to Leave, wherever you live. This program is sponsored by Dutch, the full-color English language magazine about the Netherlands and its people, at home and abroad.
As you can see, we have clear skies, very little wind, the perfect conditions for my next activity. As you can see, we're heading straight for Utrecht.
And you're not just lucky with the wind, Mark. What a beautiful evening to take to the skies of Utrecht.
It's really a cool way to see the city from a complete different angle. If you get the opportunity, take it. The province of Utrecht provides you with a lot of cycle tracks. The shortest is 19 kilometers. I think I'm going to take that one.
All throughout Utrecht, there are possibilities to rent bikes. Cycling the marked routes in Utrecht's attractive surroundings gives you the opportunity to escape the city's fuss.
Gym. Goeiedag.
In Utrecht, almost every neighborhood has its own park. All the parks have their own unique elements, so walking around them gives you a great insight of the city's identity. Astonished by the classic buildings, Mark walks into Utrecht's largest museum, the Centraal Museum.
This oldest city museum of the Netherlands
has a rich art collection dating from before Christ to present day.
Before Amsterdam and Haarlem flourished to become the home of the Dutch masters, Utrecht was the painter's capital of the Netherlands. The early Italian masters inspired painters like Moreelse, who would later inspire Rembrandt. The Centraal Museum also has a rather large collection of Utrecht's Caravaggists. Aside from the permanent collection, the Centraal Museum prides itself in many temporary exhibitions throughout the year. The museum is open every day from 11 to 5. A ticket is also valid for the Dick Bruna House and Rietveld Schroeder House. Mark gratefully uses this opportunity to visit the Dick Bruna House. Dick Bruna is the author of Holland's most famous little bunny rabbit, Miffy. The children's books have been translated into 40 different languages and have sold over 85 million copies worldwide.
A nice present for my little nephew.
The Dick Bruna House tells the story of Dick Bruna's life and the development of the Miffy character. It's a very child-friendly museum. Another part of the Centraal Museum is at Rietveld Schroeder House. This house is the only building based on the architectural principles of the stijl ever realized. Originally from Utrecht, Gerrit Rietveld is best known for his red, blue and yellow furniture and interior design. The Aboriginal Art Museum Utrecht is the only museum in Europe for contemporary Aboriginal art from Australia. The unique collection educates the public on the diverse art forms of the youngest Aboriginal generation. Every year, the museum presents 2 to 3 changing exhibitions. In the Universiteitsmuseum, one can discover everything about the sciences, from the past and the present. In the Knowledge Lab and Youth Lab, a hands-on experience teaches you about the world around you. Behind the museum, you can walk in the beautiful old botanical gardens of the old Hortus.
The Netherlands have a unique reputation when it comes to religion, and I've heard they can tell me all about that here.
Museum Katharijnenconvent is the national museum for Christian art and culture and houses one of the largest Christian art collections in the world, from medieval manuscripts to 16th and 17th century paintings and textiles.
This museum contains both Catholic and Protestant art, which makes it unique in the world.
Museum Katharijnenconvent's collections focuses on the early medieval to the 21st century. Next to that, it offers exhibitions with more international backgrounds. It's time for Mark to take a closer look to the most important feature of Utrecht skyline.
What's special about the Dome Tower is that it's separated from the church. That's because in the 17th century, a tornado completely destroyed the middle section.
Built in 1254 as a Protestant church, the Dome is also one of the most important Gothic monuments of the country. At the tourist board, it is possible to book a guided tour and climb the enormous tower.
...465 steps.
With its 112 meters, it is the highest church building in the Netherlands. The church and tower are open daily, and for only €7.50, you can climb the tower, as Mark has done.
This is really worth climbing. Spectacular view.
This program is sponsored by Dutch, the full-color English language magazine about the Netherlands and its people, at home and abroad.
City of Utrecht in the evening, you'll be sure to catch many of the illuminated buildings. These are part of the Direct and Lumen project. Renowned lighting designers are featured all over the city, honoring its rich history.
Trajectum Lumen ensures a continually changing city landscape. A play of beautiful illuminating artworks leaves the visitor with a lively impression of the city, an illusion that is spot on. Utrecht also offers many cultural activities in the evening. Mark has chosen for the Beatrix Theater, named after the Dutch queen. Theatre restaurant, one can choose from an elaborate a la carte menu.
Utrecht really has a lot to offer. It's a creative city where, besides theatres, all kinds of festivals are organised during the year.
That's right. This city's cultural scene is very much in motion. One of Utrecht's highlights are the so-called Cultural Sundays. On several Sundays, you'll find cultural activities all over the place. From all the festivals in Utrecht, the most famous is the Dutch Film Festival. The Stad Schouwburg, the city theatre, offers more than 450 shows a year. The amazing Douwe Egbertzaal can facilitate 1,000 people. The programme covers shows from Shakespeare to musicals and from operas to cabaret.
European Festival will take place this year on May 26th at the Swangard Stadium in Burnaby.
Tulip TV will be there, so we'd love to see you there. Additionally, we're looking for volunteers, so check out our website for the details. See you there. So, don't forget, if you want to support us or follow us, do so via Twitter, Facebook or YouTube, or otherwise just use the old-fashioned way and speak to your friends.
And if you want to donate, go to our website, click donation, or email us.
Duh!
Duh, Mal!